Well, first of all, thank you for the opportunity to allow me to address you and tell you some of the things that are going on in the city. What I'm going to do here is, first of all, tell you what our goals were for 2014, then describe how we've done on that, then tell you where we're going for 2015 with regard to those goals and take it from there. After that, I'm going to open up for questions. So I'm not going to take a great deal of time doing some of these other things. Most of you are probably pretty well aware of what's going on. Is this on? Can you hear me? Okay. Sorry? No, this one works. Okay. The council goals for 2014 divided pretty much into three areas: financial, aesthetics, and infrastructure. On the financial, we had goals of reviewing the master fees and charges, updating our council's policy on debt, which we did do. We set a limit, the budget committee has set a limit of $250 million for non-GO debt. So we're not there, but you know, we're going to try it. We will stay below that. And we're going to complete the 2013 action plan to sell the web. More on that in a little bit. Aesthetics, our goal is to complete the 2013 action plan for updating the comp plan. We had wanted to adopt changes to development code to implement sensitive lands code changes. We wanted to amend the tree code, nothing controversial there, of course, to address large land parcels. And long term, we want to convene a community dialogue on the tree code because it's going to take that. Again, these are 2014 goals. Infrastructure, we wanted to continue to invest in street maintenance so that we get our paving index up to 70. It's now at about 65, 64, but we're getting there, and it takes a couple of years to get up there. We wanted to adopt a design and funding strategy for improving the operations center, which is the maintenance facility for first responders and others in the city. Wanted to develop a financially feasible program for a common facility in Lake Grove. That's one of our big problems as far as a library goes. If you talk with Bill, is we don't have enough meeting rooms, so we're trying to get some community facilities to satisfy that need, both in Lake Grove and Lake Oswego. And then we want to complete a new or expanded police LOCOM center, because the LOCOM center is not right now earthquake proof or seismically safe. So we want to do that too. Okay, how'd we do? Well, the comprehensive plan we finished last year. Now, this is a 3-year project. We can't take credit for all that. 3-year project, but we got through it last year and finished it up, making some changes to reflect the council's philosophy. We also completed the transportation system plan, which tends to be a big deal. Again, this is not something that just happened overnight. We can't take all the credit for it. We did finish it. We made some changes, again, on philosophy. We decided that the transportation system didn't place enough emphasis on vehicles, cars, that kind of thing. It looked like we were planning more on bikes and pathways and that sort of thing. And we want to make sure that since most people use automobiles to travel around this city, that we didn't denigrate the emphasis on that. So that was part of what we did. We also took pathways that were on public property, on private property. We took those off the transportation plan because we're trying to protect people's rights rather than saying, okay, we're going to put a public pathway across your land. Sensitive lands program. This is a big deal, and we've made progress on it. Last year, we had what they call quick fixes, about 9 of them that we put in to ameliorate some of the effects of the sensitive lands program. It's a start right now, and we'll go into this a little bit later. We're continuing to work on the sensitive lands program, and we'll go into that later and give you an update on that. Well, we got through the process anyway. And I know everybody doesn't agree with where we went, but we got through the process. It's going forward, and I think it's going to be a good thing. North Anchor. These are the properties that are, let's see, State Street and B, this property up here. This was originally going to be acquired when we were going to put the streetcar in. City bought the property, three parcels right now. There's a fourth we're thinking about doing on. But the idea is this property needs to be developed. and Laura is involved. They're the ones that own, that purchased it. Lake Oswego owns them. And the idea is we're going to develop this to make it, you know, increase our tax base and make the city a better place in that area. And so the plan then was to get going on the North Anchor properties. The web, what a surprise. That was one of our goals too, was to get the web sold, make a decision, get it sold. We didn't get there last year. There were, as you know, the negotiations with first Kensington and then with Nick Bunick didn't get us where we wanted to be. So we still own that. More on that when we come up to our next goals. The Southwest Employment Area, this is the area that is east of I-5 and south of Lakeview, Pilkington, and that area, where we think that we should be having more industrial land there. And we want to get businesses in there, again, increase our tax base, get more people that can not only live here but work here. And we convened a group of a number of people to discuss that and move forward on some plans for it. Now, this is an interesting thing. You know, Google came in last year and said, gee, we want to bring high-speed fiber optics for you guys. We'll give you, what was it, 100 meg or
1 gigabyte.
Yeah, well, pretty fast for residential. And it sounded really good. We signed an agreement to allow them to put in huts for the thing. And then they decided, we're not ready to do you guys yet. So we'll talk to you later. We're not going to let it stand quite like that. There are other options to us. We're discussing that right now. The water project is moving forward. This is the Waluga Reservoir that's over by Carmen Road and the Waluga. We're moving forward on the project. We're still on schedule to finish the project in 2016, with the exception of the, the flocking? Whatever. One part of the water thing that is over on Mapleton Drive that's in the water treatment area. We will be delivering water right now. We're scheduled to deliver water to Tigard on schedule in June of next year. There is going to be a delay to finish the last little parts of that water treatment plan, but that's the only thing that's being delayed at this point. And we are on schedule. We're all on schedule as far as the budget goes as well. And last year, we adopted a council vacancy policy. You may or may not recall that when Mike Kehoe resigned a couple of years ago, we had to replace him, find somebody to replace him. And so we didn't have a real policy, and it was a little bit messy. So we've adopted a policy that we think will at least reduce the mess a little bit and make it easier in case somebody resigns. I'm not sure. Did we have something in there about resignation of the mayor?
No.
But there's always, you know, you can always vote him out or whatever. Okay. Now, this is our new volunteer coordinator. The budget committee wanted somebody to be a coordinator for the projects that are being done, because it helps us get those projects done. It helps us use more volunteers, which is financially a good thing for the city. This is Babs Hamacek. She just took on the job about a month ago, isn't that right? She's a real fireball and be a real asset for us. Now, as far as the finances go, infrastructure go, last year we finished a major project, a $2 million project to redo Kerr Parkway and put sidewalks and everything else. It has really come out well, and we finally finished that last year. This is coming up. Now, we're spending money on this already. We're getting out a design contract to do the design on Boone's Ferry, but we're moving along on this thing. We've already had teams that have gone out and talked to the property owners there to see how they feel about maybe losing some right-of-way or letting us buy some of their right-of-way. So we're moving on that thing. Operations Center, this is what I'm talking about. This is where our first responders are. It's down on Jean Road right now. It is really outdated, and so we really need to fix that. The cost is about $13 million. We've set aside at least half of that money right now in reserves from this year's budget, and we're going to try and set aside more right now. But again, we're moving ahead on this. We should be able to complete this without going to the taxpayers for any more money. So that'll be a good thing. We'll get that done, and we'll have a facility that is usable. Oh, I'm sorry. Thanks. Okay. And then the police low-com center, again, we're moving ahead on that. I'll get into that in just a little bit. But we need to, we've been looking at various areas from the parking lot at the web to city facilities or whatever to make it so that the police have a decent place to be where they're not operating out of closets and where the dispatch center is in a seismically safe area. Okay, so here are our present goals. We just set these about a month ago. Finish the sensitive land revision, convene a city discussion, move forward on a tree code revision, continue improving infrastructure, streamline the development code, develop plans for the North Anchor and the Southwest Industrial Area, and improve the effectiveness of LO city government. This project here, finish the sensitive lands revisions. We should be done with that in June of this year. Right now we're working on plans, and council has approved them. We're going to go to Metro, and both Metro and DEQ are involved in this. We're going to go to them with our present plan and say, okay, guys, here it is. This should take care of things. See what they say. We're cautiously optimistic on that. We already did have a discussion, and we passed a new revision on the tree code for large forested lots. Those are ones with an acre or more that has at least 100% canopy, tree canopy. It's a big improvement for those people who have property like that. But we've got a lot more to do on the tree code, and we're going to convene a community forum like we did on the North Anchor property. It worked out very well. We're going to do the same kind of thing to get input from the citizens about what kind of changes they want in the tree code, if they want anything. Well, we got to find that out. The rest of it, you can see that. I mean, I don't have to go into big discussions on this. Improving the effectiveness of city government, I guess I should leave. I mean, these guys are doing such a good job, I could take a 2-year sabbatical and, you know, it'd be great. Okay, the idea though is we want to make steady progress. We want to just kind of we're going along now. We don't want to stir up things unnecessarily. We're going to continue focus on infrastructure and on things that the city needs. This, in case you don't recognize him, this is our city manager. This is his wife Sandy. Scott has done a super job for us. He really has. He's communicates with all of our employees. He's met with every single one of the employees. He has meetings weekly with city councilors, and he's brought a creativity and a professionalism to the office that's tremendous. As a result of his leadership, for example, every department is run as its own business. They get their money, they do what they're supposed to do with it. If they have money left over, then they can use that in the next year. But they got to get the job done. They're trying to be as economical as possible. Let's see what else. Oh, all right. Questions? Rob?
I drive by the new Street of Dreams that's going in on Noss Road pretty much every day on the way to work. And I noticed that while the new development has, you know, sidewalks, that it's kind of hit and miss along Noss Road. You've got a block with a sidewalk and a no sidewalk, and some concern when you've got 25,000 people coming to Street of Dreams, how they're going to get there without having a pathway. Is there any thoughts on how that might be accomplished so we don't have a mess here in the summer?
It's a big deal, and that's a big deal for the developers too. They've got all sorts of shuttles scheduled. They really got it. Maybe Scott, you can give them a little bit more information if you need to. Yeah. Yeah, there's a lot of planning that's going into that to take care of that.
And the plan is not to have anyone park there. It will all be shuttled from Megan to the high school or in the junior high.
Yeah. More about walking.
Yeah. Now, just one thing. I'd be remiss also if I didn't tell you that we have a tremendous city council, people that are willing to work creatively and collegially, and it's been tremendous. We also have a great staff. These are people that work hard and do a great job, and we're trying to get it so that they're really customer-oriented, so that you feel like they're working for you. And I should also say we've got the budget committee, which is city council, 7 members of the city council plus 7 members at large. There's a meeting right now, and they're doing a great job. It takes a lot of time and a lot of searching in all the numbers and everything. They're doing a super job of bringing forth issues and resolving them. All right, more questions. Yes, Cliff.
I noticed that the web wasn't on your goal list any longer. Is it? And I also thought that bids were supposed to be opened here recently.
Yeah, thanks for bringing that up. You're exactly right. Bids have already come in. We put it out with Cushman Wakefield a couple months ago. They put out a request for bids, and they got in 11 bids. And there's only a couple of them that really aren't worth looking at, but they're really looking good. And we're going to do a little more research with each one of them and then figure out which one we're going to go with. We're feeling very, very good about that. Yes?
Kent, I live in West Lynn, and the water project obviously has made a complete disaster of Highway 43.
Yep, yep.
And I know they put in what they're calling a patch this
yep.
last couple of weeks, but that's also a bit of a disaster. Is there a long-range plan
yep.
to fix 43?
Yeah, there sure is. With the temporary patches that they're putting in now should be done by the end of this month. The final paving for that whole project along Highway 43 is supposed to be done by the end of this summer. So I drive that thing too. It's a mess, but it'll be done soon. Other questions? Wow. Yes. Sharon.
I'd just like to compliment you on the great new signage that you have, including the one that's down here on George Rogers Park. Nice addition.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Yes, Tom.
Hi, vis-a-vis the North Anchor project, does that include any changes to the library? And I'll tell you why. I live out on Westlake, and we have no library. And so they're talking about doubling downtown and just leaving no library out there. I wonder if we could have 2 libraries.
Tom.
Who's going for 3?
Thank you for your question. You turkey. I was on the library advisory board last year, and we had a lot of discussion about that. The problem is, same thing as anything, is where do you get the money for it? Now, we had the bond issue, and it didn't pass. What we're trying to do, though, is, again, accommodate the needs out there. We've put drop boxes out there. We're trying to get meeting rooms, as I said, as a part of the Boone's Ferry project, getting meeting rooms out there in Lake Grove, as well as perhaps when we get the LOCOM Center, putting a meeting room down on the bottom floor of that. But, yeah, it's from what Mr. Bars has told us, it's not so much the library as the meeting rooms that we really need to do.
So you're not talking about doubling the size of the one on the east side again anymore?
No.
They were at one point.
I'm sorry, no. We're not. Yes,
yeah,
Joshua.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Yeah.
For the Boone's Ferry project, how far, I know there was some talk at some point of doing an island or something in between to kind of help traffic flow.
Yep.
Where is that conversation?
That's still the plan. The idea is if you put medians in there, that gives you a place where people can make U-turns and actually provides more access to the businesses along Boone's Ferry Road. So yes, those are still in there. Yeah. Mark?
Mark, waiting for the mic.
By the way, on the LOCOM Center, just so you know, we are bidding on a piece of property right next to City Hall. It's a doctor's office. And if we can get that, that's where we're probably going to put the police LOCOM Center. It has a lot of advantages in cutting down the expense, and it makes it so that the police and LOCOM are still in the downtown area.
Ken, what's the plan for the maintenance center? Is it all going to be on that campus, or are you doing something new?
All on the campus, right? Yes, we're going to keep it where it is. What we're doing, though, in the meantime, is we've signed a lease for property down in Foothills to be a kind of a staging area for things that are going on while they're doing work at the operations center. Other questions?
Well, okay. That's great. Thank you very much.
Well, wait a minute. Okay. I know it's the Rotary's tradition to give somebody a book when they speak, so I thought I'd reverse that. And I'm going to give Rotary a book from me. This says, presented by the Lake to the Lake Oswego Rotary for Knowledge and Benefit by Ken Studebaker, Mayor of the City of Lake Oswego. The book is called The Truth About Government. And it's blank inside.